Hello, I'm Stefano Musardo.
And I'm Giuseppe Giannotti.
And we are two members of the Student Committee for FENS Forum 2040, and we are pleased to introduce you the video interview of FENS Forum speakers.
Good morning. It's a pleasure for me to introduce Dr. Pietro De Camilli. Dr. Pietro De Camilli is a professor of cell biology and neurobiology at the Yale School of Medicine, and his research is focused on the study of mechanisms underlying dynamic and traffic of cell membranes in physiology and disease. So, Dr. Pietro De Camilli, please introduce yourself and tell us about your professional background.
So, I was educated in Italy, in fact, in Milano, the site of the meeting, with a thesis in the CNA, National Reserve Council Unit of the Department of Medical Pharmacology. Subsequently, I moved to the United States to join Paul Gringer as a postdoctoral fellow. After that, I became a junior faculty, but then I decided to come back to Europe. I stayed in Europe for a few years, and then finally I went back to stay in the United States at Yale. I'm currently a professor of cell biology and neurobiology at the Medical School of Yale University. I'm also an investigator in the Howard Hughes Medical Institute and a founding director of the Yale program in cellular neuroscience, neurodegeneration and repair. My work is at the interface between fundamental cell biology and neurobiology, and I'm interested in the mechanism in the role of membrane traffic and membrane dynamic in the processes that support synaptic transmission and in the dysfunction of these processes in disease.
So please give us a preview of your lecture at FENS Forum 2014.
Yeah, so the title of my lecture will be Cell Biology of the Neuron, Membrane Lipid Dynamics in the Regulation of Synaptic Function. An important goal of my lab is to elucidate mechanism underlying the exo-endocytic recycling of synaptic vesicles. Synaptic vesicles are the small organelles that store neurotransmitter at synapses. They release their content by fusion with the plasma membrane. They release the neurotransmitter in the synaptic cleft, and they are rapidly reformed by endocytosis and recycling of their membrane. A fascinating question in neurobiology is how these organelles are continuously faithfully regenerated after recycle of exoendocytosis, resulting in vesicle of precise molecular composition and precise homogeneous size. Much has been learned about these processes, both in my lab and in many other labs, by the study of proteins, but in my talk at the meeting, I will discuss the role of lipids, or membrane lipids. The cell biology of membrane lipid, it is infancy, but is one of the most exciting and rapidly developing areas of cell biology, and in particular, one that is increasingly recognized as highly relevant to the field of neurodegenerative disease. So that's going to be my talk.
So which are the approaches that you use for the study of biogenesis and traffic of synaptic vesicles?
Well, I use a wide variety of approaches, and I would say that that is a typical, is the defining feature of my laboratory, to use an interdisciplinary approach. Our work range from work biochemistry to identify component, a reconstitution of cell biological processes under cell precondition, and then doing studies in living cell, culture neurons, up all the way to study with mice. We generate a variety of mutant mice, and then we really approach our question and our hypothesis, and we test our hypothesis with work that ranges from work in vivo to work in a test tube. And obviously, we are very interested also in diseases. I was trained as an MD, so ultimately my goal is to understand how disease work, and increasingly, we explore connection between our work and neurological and psychiatric diseases. Now that the gene implicated in many diseases are being identified at a very rapid pace, this identification offers tremendous opportunity to learn about connection between cell biology and clinical problems.
So why should students and young neuroscientists attend to FENS Forum 2014?
Yeah, I think that it is very important for a young scientist to be exposed to a broad range of topics. It's very important to identify direction in which it's important to work. I also think it is very important to acquire personal knowledge of the key players in the field, either through personal encounter or just by listening to the talk. In my experience, listening to a talk of an author whose work I've read or directly meeting the person has a big impact on the way I perceive the validity of the work they've generated. And finally, an important thing, in particular for students, this meeting is a great opportunity to meet potential mentors and to decide what to do next in their career.
So what are you most looking forward at the forum?
Yeah, well, the large meetings are a great opportunity to see where neuroscience is going, to see the birth of new field, and to continuously redefine the direction of my research. It's also a great opportunity to meet the new people, the newcomer to the field. And finally, last but not the least, is a great opportunity to see colleagues and many old friends.
Do you want to leave a message for students and young researchers?
Yeah, it's very simple. Choose the right mentors and choose the right topic. For mentor, I mean you should look for not only for people that do great science, but people that are, personality that you can look up to. And the choosing of a mentor is probably the most important thing that you can do in your career. About question, if you have to spend your time doing hard work, and there is no way to be successful in science without doing hard work, is much better to do that an important question. So don't rush into a field. Think about, put down solid foundation, and then on this foundation you can build your whole career. But the key thing is to look for important questions.
So thank you, Dr. Pietro De Camilli, for your kind participation. And for everyone, please don't miss his lecture and see you at FENS Forum 2014. Bye-bye.